Welcome back, trainers, and in this video we have some fantastic news regarding Mega Evolutions as well as trading. You're going to be able to trade a little bit further, and Mega Evolution energy is going to be a little bit easier to obtain. So starting it off with the trading here, as a limited test from Thursday, November 12th at 2 p.m. until Monday, November 16th, 10 a.m. PST. And then they go on to say if this test run is successful, that they're going to include it in future events. All right, so they didn't really specify on the range, on how much further it is going to be for us to be able to trade with each other. But going over some information gathered by people here, it looks like it's going to be about 12 kilometers or 7.4 miles. Now, I don't know if that's going to be the exact numbers, but it seems like that is so far the range that we can trade. That's pretty awesome. Now, personally, for myself, Anchorage is pretty spread out. But I do believe I have people on my friends list that I would be able to trade with within this mile range here. Absolutely amazing. Now think about if you live in a city, you're going to be able to trade with all kinds of people. Well, at least the people that you do have on your friends list if they are within the proximity of this range here. It's a pretty nice little addition. And let's just hope that they add a world trade one day. But it's a step in the right direction. Pretty awesome stuff. Like I said, we'll go over all of my traded Pokemon here in a moment. Really briefly here, it looks like we're going to be getting Meltan clothing. And yeah, I think that's going to be revolving around the whole Pokemon home and how you get a Melmetal and stuff like that. So we'll see how that works out. We're going to get a little event, maybe shiny Meltans, but they didn't say that. We'll just have to see. Now, regarding the Megas, when you do have them equipped, when you do earn a candy, depending on the kilometers, as you can see, I'll get one candy and then 15 Mega Energy. And you're also going to be able to get additional Mega Energy for catching Pokemon of the same type, apparently. So that is also going to be fantastic. Regarding the energy that you're going to be getting from the kilometers, that's 15 of those. The 5 is kind of covered up by the Mega Energy there, but that's pretty nice. A nice little touch for you to get even more, including that they did add a while back that the Megas will be able to stay a little bit longer. So, Niantic's listening there, trying to improve the Mega system. I know a lot of people are not happy that it's dependent on raiding, but looks like you're going to be able to actually step out of that by earning candies by walking or potentially catching or even maybe tasks. So let's go ahead and take a look. I've typed in traded and it is bringing up all of the traded Pokemon that I do have here. You're going to see a lot of lucky, of course, and there's going to be a few that are not lucky, as well as horrible IVs, and they're going to be maxed out. Now, let me explain here. So back when I did those duos and trios and formatting those raids and we needed something on the spot that was going to potentially help us take out this raid, we would trade or take one from another that was a high CP already, and we would just top it off and we'd be good to go. That's pretty much why you're going to see horrible IVs like this one here. We did have another shiny that we traded, Mir, and I just needed to get a little bit more CP, so I just used it. We needed Smackdown and we didn't have anything better at the time, and that's why I maxed this shiny out right here. So there's the explanation if you see horrible IVs. Now, what is my take on, what IVs I should be powering up? Well, honestly, the best that you can get, I mean, you don't need me to tell you that, right? But you can, not going to say drive yourself crazy trading and not getting the best IVs and never powering anything up because you feel it's not the best. But you have to understand that IVs play a good part in a lot of things in breaking points. But most of the time, if you have 13, 14, or even 12, you're still going to be perfectly fine. It's still going to be great. Obviously, 100 is always going to be the best that you can get if you're looking for Master League or raiding, right? But you're not necessarily going to have those complete IVs, the best that you can get, to completely max it out. As you can see, I've been powering up and maxing out all kinds of horrible IVs. Again, with the Smackdown, the better one came out and I needed them on hand. Somebody traded to me, or I had them like at a high CP again and I just topped them off. So as we're taking a look at these Pokemon, I want to talk about something else as well. So trading, when you do that, you typically think, all right, I want to get the best IVs most of the time, but there are going to be Pokemon where you're going to actually want to tank their IVs. And not only that, but specific trainers are going to have to be picking up eggs at a specific level, low enough for them to be in a specific lead, like Volibee or Ponyard. But there's also going to be Pokemon that you can get through the breakthrough box, specifically a Lugia that I personally do have. We'll be taking a look at that at the end. That CP was low enough when you did catch it, as well as having a low enough friendship for the potential overall IVs to turn out not so great. and that's a recipe for a legendary to go into the Great League when it was not able to previously. Now, personally for myself, I do trade shinies with people when I'm not lucky, but I really don't like to do that because it's kind of like a waste of a shiny, because might as well wait until you become lucky friends. I know that may be a while for some people and you may be impatient, or you're just not even impatient, you're just like, you know, let's just trade it to see if it can go lucky. If it's like a community day Pokemon, you know, that's a different story. We have a ton of those. If it goes bad, that you just transfer it, you know, so sad. But if it's something that's, you know, around the rare, you know, line, then you may want to wait until you get lucky friends with somebody instead of just trading them with your one lucky trade a day. I would recommend with your one trade, special trade a day, it's going to be a legendary that you have multiple of, that is not going to be like something super rare like a Dialga. If you're going to do a Dialga raid, or I should say, we all want to do those, right? If you're going to do a Dialga trade, I would urge you to probably wait until you get lucky friends with somebody, because we haven't really seen those too often. But maybe like a Lugia or things that just continuously come back, you may want to go ahead and just trade those without becoming lucky friends, because you have plenty of them, right? But those legacies, legendaries, like the three birds, you may want to hold on to those, right? Just giving you a little tip. These are my personal pet peeves that I like to follow. If somebody has a request, I'm not going to be a stickler and be like, no, you're not getting it. No, I have a rule and I don't want to break it. I'll give them whatever they want. I don't care. But, you know, just giving you a few tips here, and maybe you can pick some up. So these are my Pokemon, folks. What do you think? Kind of a lot of these lucky ones here. And I do have a legacy lucky when it first came out, because it was actually broken and the IVs were not going to be a flat 10. It's like the attack tanked in one of them. So I have quite the extensive collection here. A lot of them I'm just simply holding on to because they're lucky. I'm probably not going to do too much with it. This Toxicroak actually, as when I do equip it as best buddy, becomes $24.99 in the Ultra League, which is pretty nice. That's Pinsir. I don't know why I'm holding on to that. I think I'm potentially waiting for some sort of cup around the Ultra League, because I've been thinking about this for a while. You know, I'm not going to say, oh, I knew it all this time, but they're starting to finally roll out these individual cups, and I want to keep some of these things. Oh, that Drapion. I almost want to transfer it. Those IVs are horrible. I maxed it out and best buddied it. Ugh. Are you absolutely joking? So we have all these different Pokemon collecting those Mewtwos. Those are from friends from the past that or present that I'm just holding on to. You know, it's kind of memorabilia. Just a few other random things here. The Tauros, it's because I can't get those in Alaska, so I'm just holding on to them. That's my collection. We don't need to run through all of them because it's kind of a lot. But like I said, remember, if you have like multiple of those Axews or something rare that we may get a community day in the future, you may want to hold on to those. So Lucario can also be, or should I say Ryolu, can be traded, and its IVs can tank for you to have it in the Great League. Ryolu is actually going to be pretty good in the Little Cup. But you also can hatch one, and the IVs can be low enough for you to use it in there as well. I personally made one. And here is the Lugia here that is actually in the Great League and shiny. I couldn't believe it. We made this trade a long time ago in the mall, and man, oh man, it was very exciting. So anyways, if you did enjoy this video and my run through of all these Pokemon, please give it a big thumbs up. And this is awesome in the direction Niantic is going. Hopefully they can continue with it. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. Take care.